In this video, we'll be looking at these LED floodlights from Ledvance, including this reasonably sized one that I think may look good on the back of my house and should be bright enough to illuminate the garden. So what sets these LED floods apart from other LED floods that are on the market? Well, let's take this 50 watt fitting from the Gen 3 range as an example. For starters, there's quality. These fittings are really well made and have been designed to be used in a variety of situations, from residential to commercial, and can actually be placed in a variety of positions without affecting the durability of the fitting. So, for example, if you wanted to use them to illuminate a facade from below, they can be tilted back to point upwards without affecting their ability to keep out moisture. Another real strength of this range is just that, the range. This style of fitting is available in black or white, warm white at 3000 Kelvin or neutral white at 4000 Kelvin, and in 10, 20 or 50 watts. Now, it would be good if we as an industry continue to move away from rating lighting by their power and keep getting used to rating them by their light output. So these fittings are available in 1100, 2200 and 5500 lumens for the warm white, and slightly higher outputs of 1200, 2400 and 6000 lumens for the neutral white. Just so you've got a reference to work from, a typical recessed LED downlight outputs about 600 lumens. Another thing that I really like on these fittings is that the motion detectors on them can be adjusted using the usual lux level and time on the dials, but there's also this third adjustment option on here that changes the sensitivity of the PIR. So if the fitting is mounted at 2.5 meters off the floor, the distance that the PIR will detect can be changed from approximately 2 meters all the way up to 12 meters, with a corresponding change in the detection angle of the detector as well. This means it can be used to illuminate small areas, reducing nuisance triggering from outside the property, but it would also work just as well on a property with, say, a long driveway or something like that. And another really helpful feature is that the motion detector is rated at IP65 as well as the fitting. That's something to look out for with floods, as often the PIR will have a lower IP rating than the fitting that it's attached to. And of course, you can override the PIR and just leave the fitting turned on by switching the power to the flood on, off, on, off, on, and it will remain permanently on. Then turning the power off for 5 seconds will reset the PIR, and when you next turn it on, it will go into normal operating mode. Now, if that isn't giving you the light output that you require, then this may be more your speed. It's very unlikely that you'll be installing this on a residential property. It's far more likely to be installed on, say, a commercial installation to provide security and safe passage around the building. It's physically much larger than the previous fitting and comes in 4000 Kelvin neutral white, again with a range of lumen outputs at 7700, 10,000, 15,000 and a whopping 20,000 lumens. Again, with that kind of range available, these will be well suited to a lot of different applications, right up to the very largest. Now, you may have noticed another difference with this fitting. It's got no motion detector attached to it. Control for this fitting is provided by a photocell, and it's incredibly discreet. It just sits on the back here and monitors the light level at this position. And that'll bring the fitting on when it gets dark and turn it off when it gets light again. Of course, if you don't want the fitting to be on all night, then you can simply pair it with an additional control in the form of a timer. Another small feature that I love as well, it's no secret that I love a good angle, and on a well-designed lighting installation, the fittings will have been calculated as sitting at specific angles in order to create the required illumination. And Ledvance have provided this handy angle guide on the bracket here to make sure that you get it to just the right setting. And just while we're looking at the bracket, there's another really good feature on all of the floods from Ledvance, and that's the angled bracket that they all have. This small but important tweak to the traditional design means that you can get to the back of the fitting for wall mounting without removing the bracket from the fitting, which means that you don't have to resort to using the world's shortest screwdriver or flaying the skin off your knuckles when you're screwing it to the wall. That is a good solid bit of kit. But we're not done, because we have this absolute behemoth of a fitting as well from the Ledvance performance range. Now, obviously this isn't going to be installed on a domestic property, unless of course that property happens to have a five-a-side football pitch in its grounds. It does come in smaller physical sizes and lumen outputs in this range as well. In fact, it's available in so many values that I'm not going to list them all here, but it goes from 5,800 lumens all the way up to 40,600 lumens, and again is available in 3,000 and 4,000 Kelvin versions. Now, as we say, these are not designed for domestic use, but rather are for illuminating large outdoor spaces, perhaps car parks or shopping centres, or even on masts for paths and even sports arenas. And that's reflected in the fact that the performance range is rated at IP66. Another feature that makes this fitting suitable for use on a range of installations are these little bubbles inside here. Now, they're actually lenses that focus and distribute the light in different ways. If you look really closely, you can see that on this specific fitting, the lenses are rounded on the underside, but along the top, they're sort of flattened off, meaning that the light is distributed in a way that's referred to as asymmetric. This means that the light can be sent out and delivered to the areas where it's really needed, meaning that because of the way that light travels and illuminates surfaces that it hits, you actually get a more uniform light level across the area that you're lighting up. It's very clever, and this range has both symmetrical and asymmetrical options available. So the Ledvance floodlight family is robust, flexible, and varied. You'll always find a suitable fitting for your installation. But as always, we want to hear from you. Which of these fittings could you see yourself using on an upcoming job? Are you growing more comfortable thinking in lumens rather than watts? Whatever your thoughts or questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.